Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. On today's episode, let's look at how you can type on your Mac like a pro. MACMOST is brought to you by a community of more than 350 supporters. Find out how you can become a part of it at MACMOST.com/Patreon. So if you spend a lot of time writing on your Mac, then it pays to know all the tips and tricks to make using your keyboard easier and more efficient. And the key to efficiency is using the arrow keys more and the mouse or trackpad less. So I'm going to use Pages to demonstrate, but these techniques will work in just about any word processor or other place you type, like say Mail, Safari, TextEdit, etc. Now I find a lot of people use the mouse or trackpad to move the cursor and click somewhere else in the text to reposition where the cursor is located. But that means taking one hand off the keyboard then putting it back on again. A lot of times it's more efficient to use the arrow keys. You can use the left arrow key to go back and the right arrow key to go forward. You can also use the up arrow key to go to the line above and the down arrow key to go to the line below. So it's pretty quick to move around in the text using just the arrow keys. But in addition to that, you can use the option key to modify it. Instead of going one character at a time, you can jump per word, which makes things really fast. You can go left or right. Now you can also do this using the down and up arrow. If you go option down, it goes to the end of the paragraph. Option up goes to the beginning of the paragraph. Likewise, the command key can be used to go to the end of the actual line. So not the end of the paragraph, but the end of the line. So command right arrow goes to the end of the line here. Left arrow goes there. So if you have multiple paragraphs, the down arrow key will go one line at a time. The up arrow key back up. Option down will go to the end of each paragraph and option up will go to the beginning of each paragraph. Now even people that use the arrow keys for moving the cursor around will sometimes resort to using the cursor for selecting text. They'll click and drag over text to select it. But you can use the arrow keys for that as well. For instance, if I were to hold the shift key down and use the left arrow, it selects backwards one character at a time. If I were to release the shift key and then start moving normally using the arrow keys, the selection goes away. If I do shift right arrow, then it selects forward one character at a time. Likewise, I can use shift and then option, and then I do one word at a time. And then shift, option, and left will do one word at a time in reverse. And you can use the other keys as well. So I can go back to the beginning of the line and I could do shift and then down arrow for that line, or I can do shift, option, down arrow for the entire paragraph. So these same modifier keys work with the delete key as well. So usually hitting the delete key once will delete one character at a time. But if I use option delete, it goes one word at a time. You can also use command delete to delete all the way to the beginning of the line. Now one big difference between a Mac keyboard and a Windows keyboard is there's a forward delete button on a standard Windows keyboard. You can forward delete on a Mac too. You need to look for the FN key, hold that down, and then use delete and it deletes forward. You can also use the option key with this to delete the word that's forward. So one of the things that makes typing on an iPhone or iPad faster is autocomplete. And you've got autocomplete also on the Mac. So this functionality has been around for a while. You use option escape to trigger it. So you start typing a word and maybe it's a long word and you don't feel like typing the rest of the characters, or you're not sure how to complete the spelling of the word. You type option escape, it brings up a list, and you can use the down arrow to go through the list and hit return when you find the right word. So what about autocorrect? Autocorrect is when you incorrectly type a word and it automatically adjusts the spelling. You've got that on Mac as well. So let's say you type a word and you forget a letter. You can see suggestions are appearing underneath right there, and if I were to hit space, that suggestion would automatically be taken. Now a few tips for that. First of all, make sure you have edit and then spelling and grammar and check spelling while typing selected. Also make sure in system preferences under keyboard and then text you have correct spelling automatically checked. Now if you did want to use your own spelling and not the autocorrected spelling, you can use the escape key to easily cancel it. So as I type this, it wants to autocorrect it to get rid of the dash, but say I want it there for some sort of poetic effect, I hit the escape key and now I'm fine. Now I'm often asked about adding your own words to the autocorrect dictionary, but you don't need to go to all that trouble. There's a much easier thing that you could do. You can use text replacements or text substitutions for that and for all sorts of other things that will make typing easier. So the way to set this up is go into System Preferences and then keyboard, and then click on text. And you get a list of replacements and what to replace them with. Now you can use this for various things. For instance, if you find you're often typing a word wrong, you can add a correction for it. So for instance, if I find I'm always making this mistake, I could say always replace that with the correct spelling. Now you can do a lot more with it. For instance, if you look at the examples here, you see there are things like using parentheses C. Parentheses uses the special copyright character. You can also type really long things. Like for instance, I have GC help, Game Center help, that automatically types a couple sentences. And then sometimes I just have shorter things like, for instance, the domain name for the website, just 3 characters. So when I go to type these, like if I type that parentheses C parentheses, you can see it will automatically replace that. If I do HMM, you can see it replaces it with the website there, and GC help will add all of that text. So text replacements give you a whole bunch of different ways to boost your productivity. Also notice in System Preferences there are a few options here. One of them is to add a period with a double space. If you're used to doing that when typing on a phone, it comes in handy on the Mac as well. There's also the option to capitalize like the first word of a sentence automatically. And of course we can't talk about typing productivity without talking about the ability to type accent marks and special characters. So the easiest way to type an accent mark is to continue to hold down the key that you want the accent to be on. So for instance, if I want to type the word cafe and put the accent mark over the E, instead of just tapping the E key, I press and hold the E key and I have these selections here. I could use the cursor to figure out which one I want, or I can just press the number. So I'm going to hit the number 2 key and it gives me the accent mark. And this works for any key that gives you accent marks. So the O key for instance, or I, or C, anything that has an alternative character. Now for typing any special character, use the Control, Command, and Spacebar. And that brings up the special character interface here, and you can go through all the smileys and the emoji and all the special characters. You can go to different categories here at the bottom. Click the little arrow here to go to more like symbols and all sorts of things. But the best part of this is at the very top is a search. So if you just need to find something quickly, you can search for it by name. So those are all the pro typing tips I've got. To go even further, you want to look into using dictation on your Mac and combine typing on the keyboard with speaking to your Mac.